Hi guys, this is Robbie from Aster, and today I'll be showing you how you can use NextCloud account in Aster Workplaces. So let's get started. Before getting started, you need to install NextCloud application. I've already done it earlier. And when you install NextCloud for the first time, you'll need to reboot the computer once so that the NextCloud can start properly on the next boot. So I've already done those. So let me open NextCloud. And when you open the NextCloud application first time, you need to add the NextCloud account. And if you don't have one, then you can create an account by clicking on the sign up with the provider. And you can choose one of the providers listed here. And depending on how far it is, you can choose the provider, so that the closer it is, the faster it will be for synchronizing the files. I chose OPS1 as it was bit near than other places. So I already created account, so I'm not going to create account. Let me go to login. To login, you have to provide the server and this server address, then and this is displayed when you log into the cloud account for the first time, and it will be open in the browser. So I already noted it down, so I can sit here. So this is the server that I'm going to connect to, and it's going to open a browser window to connect, and you have to click on login and enter username and password. I did it earlier, so it didn't ask me to create any login with username and password, as it's already in the cookie. So after you have logged in, you need to click on grant access so that the NextCloud application can connect to the server. So once you have clicked grant access, it will be connected. And if you check in the NextCloud account, it will show you this screen, and here you can choose synchronize everything from the server. This will download all the files that are available in the cloud folder, or choose what to sync. I'm going to choose virtual files, so instead of downloading the content immediately, so this option will not download the files but display the files available on the folder. And then you can download them by double clicking the files once. Afterwards, click on connect. It will take a few seconds to connect to the server and load the files. As you can see here, it's synchronizing. So while this is happening, let me open the second workplace. I'm using Parsec to connect into the second workplace because OBS cannot record the second workplace video directly. So I've already installed NextCloud, as you see. You don't have to install NextCloud on each of the workplaces. You only have to install it once with your admin account, and then log in like before. This is same for any number of workplaces that you have on your system using Aster, and you can connect to your shared NextCloud account, and then it will be synchronized to your desktop. Synchronized to one of the folder in your desktop. And here in this second workplace, it's synchronizing to user 2, NextCloud 2 folder. And as earlier, I'm going to use virtual file instead of downloading it immediately, and then clicking on connect. So while this is happening, let's check our first workplace. And as you can see, we have check mark. That means everything was synchronized. And you can manually sync them also if you have logged out or you have set the system to offline or something like that. So it's synchronizing the files on the second workplace, as you can see here. And these two are working independently, and they are not conflicting with each other. Like some other application like Google Drive or OneDrive, they may not allow you to have two user accounts synchronized on the workplaces. So this NextCloud can be your backup or file synchronization application on Aster Workplaces. So that's about it for this video, and if you have any questions or any issue following this guide, feel free to comment in the video below, and have a good day.